We're the Student PR Committee, Public Relations Committee, and we're going to be interviewing Dean Stohler today. So the first thing that we're going to ask Dean Stohler about is tell us a little bit about yourself, like where you did dental school, why you chose to get into academia, I guess. That would be the first question that I have for you.
Okay. I started dental school in Switzerland at the University of Bern. I graduated in 1974 and decided to get into oral surgery right after dental school, which I did. And this was during the time when the reorganization of oral surgery happened worldwide, and I was in that program for 2 years, got a certificate, and after that I became a prosthodontist. And then I went to Michigan on a sabbatical, and I liked it very, very much. Came back and got appointed as a chair in Geneva, and went back to Michigan because I was too young to be a chair, and liked it so much that I stayed for 23 years at Michigan. I truly enjoyed it. I felt that academia is a wonderful way of being in dentistry. It's exciting. It's always around young people. You know, you never realize how old you get because you know the students around you are always the same age, and suddenly you wake up and you're an old man. And I must say, this country has been good to me. From Michigan, I went to Maryland, and from Maryland, I went to Columbia.
What do you think distinguishes Columbia from other places that you've been?
Well, Columbia is close to Michigan, but there's something special about Columbia. It's an Ivy League school, and it has a different kind of culture. It's a culture of excellence, a culture of accumulating passionate people that want to go places. You know, a state school usually is the school where everybody hangs around and wants to be a dentist. But when you come to Columbia, you recognize you're having a different breed of students. Students that are passionate, students that want to do something with their life, and it doesn't take you long to recognize that. You know, probably about 2 days, then you feel that you're in a different environment.
I know you've been involved with multiple schools, like you just said, and I know I read some of your interviews, and you said that you were interested, you liked the research component that Columbia has, as well as how the MEG curriculum is integrated with the dental school curriculum. And I was just wondering, what are the things, maybe from being deans and at other schools, that you would like to also integrate into Columbia, or what your vision is and what you would like to change in the future?
What I like here is the fact that the foundation sets up the curriculum for the future. You know, dentistry and medicine should be much closer together. You know, we are having a society that, you know, will have more and more diseases. You know, when we're looking at obesity and the comorbidity of obesity in younger people, such as diabetes and many autoimmune diseases, they will affect the practice of dentistry. At the same time, you have an aging population and a lot of comorbid conditions that are associated with aging. And for that reason, having a curriculum that is deeply founded in medicine is making this a very special place. I can tell you that at Maryland, it was an accident in 1840 when, you know, the dental school separated from the medical school. And today you have to ask yourself, is this the best way of doing dentistry, given that the fact that, you know, today's patients cannot see the boundaries between the disciplines, the diseases don't end up at the collar of your shirt. And, you know, in order for us to do the best for our patients, there needs to be a true integration. Because, you know, inflammation in the face and inflammation on your foot is an inflammation, and the impact is system-wide. And what I liked about Columbia is the fact that it's a school that is very well advanced to push, you know, dentistry into the forefront of where it should be. Many of us have been, you know, looking at the future of dentistry and the fact that it is so heavily procedure-driven in many dental schools makes it such that it has no viability, because a procedure-driven dental education is no different from a mid-level provider. And you would like to create people that have the ability to truly navigate patients through the healthcare system, particularly, you know, if their dental problems are significant. And I looked at the curriculum here and I felt that the first 2 years are exceptional, and I recognize that we need to do something, asking about change, something about year three and four, to give, you know, you an opportunity to practice the kind of medicine that you have been taught in the first, in the first 1.5 years, and give you opportunity that makes this student more robust when it comes to dealing with the interface between medicine and dentistry.
I completely agree. I know when I first came here and I realized how closely integrated the two curriculums were, I just heard multiple stories about how it's important that many of your patients will come in with an undiagnosed problem, and it's important that you are able to realize that and then can refer that out so they can get appropriate help.
Yeah, and now looking at the students that choose that kind of environment is probably the best the dean can look for, because it gives us an opportunity to push the curriculum into directions that many other schools are not capable of, because the students just want to do a filling, you know, and drill and bill and fill, you know. here I feel there's a different environment, and I hope that we can push dentistry to where it's supposed to be in the 21st century, you know, serving the American people in a different way than we have been doing in the last 50 years.
You touched on all the exciting things going on here, and how Columbia is one of the biggest research universities in the world, and how there's currently research that'll come and make huge changes in dentistry. Do you think that there should be more of an emphasis on entrepreneurship here on campus? I know that there's currently a health tech assembly that kind of brings together the med school and the undergrad campus, as well as the engineering school, but the dental school is not included in that. Do you think maybe we should integrate the dental school into that as well?
You could have my job. you know exactly what this is all about. Leadership means that you innovate. Mm-hmm. Leadership means that you create new things that make life better. That you dream of solutions that nobody dreamed of, and that's basically what needs to happen here. We need to liberate people so that they come up with ideas. We need to reward ideas. Mm-hmm. We need to stimulate an environment that, you know, is creative, and creative people are becoming leaders, and that's basically what needs to happen. We need to follow what we get out of the engineering school. We certainly need to better appreciate some of the advanced technologies that are emerging in medicine and see how they translate into the field of dentistry, and that will create another kind of environment in dentistry, taking advantage of what Columbia as a whole offers, definitely.
That's one thing I definitely like about this campus, is especially with the Mailman School of Public Health and the med school right here, you can really tie all the disciplines together and get one unified medical campus.
Yeah, you know, something that occurred to me, given, you know, these unique and strong schools around us, looking for dual degree opportunities for our students is something that we need to clearly look into. The possibility for passionate students to see their passion probably, you know, blossoming in another school, and giving an opportunity for getting an MPH, a Doctor of Public Health, or, you know, a Master of Medical Science, or a DDS PhD, or, you know, whatever you, or an engineering degree, or whatever you would like to do, so that the students that leave here will become the leaders in the profession, because they have a foundation that nobody else has. And I think the students that apply here deserve to be exposed to the university at large.
Lastly, what is your message to our entire student body, you know, all 4 years that are here and people coming in?
I'm grateful to be here, extremely grateful to be here. I'm grateful for the fact that this is a student body that any dean would, you know, die for. And to be able to work with this student body to make, you know, some changes that we together think are necessary for the future, and bringing in the faculty and the whole community staff to make this a special place. I know that without students we couldn't do it. It's just the students are the drivers nowadays, and I hope that we will be able to do great things together.